Alright guys, so this is part two of a video trying to show you how to cut out an image and then load it in InDesign and making sure that the text wraps around it. So if you want to watch part one, you can do so clicking on the video that's on your top right corner right now. But let's assume that everyone knows how to do a cutout by now. Let's come to File, Place. You're going to look for your image and remember that this has to be a PNG because PNGs have transparency, right? You come to this, let's select this one, Nigel Farage 2, PNG. Great, click open. And see how it gave me that little brush, and it's just gonna let me lay out this image wherever I wanted to. Now, why can't we see it? Number one, because the image is absolutely massive, and number two, because this is meant to be transparent by how we've cut it out. But if you move it forward, there you go, Mr. Farage, hello. Another thing that you might notice is that I don't have any guidelines in any bit of my document. That's because I've disabled them to be able to just see the layout as it would when I printed it out. If you hit W just by itself, you can reactivate them, or W again to deactivate them. So let's activate them again so I can actually see what I'm doing. Let's zoom out. And now you can grasp just how enormous this image is. And if we move it close to the center, we can change the size here, making sure that this little lock is selected so that it does it proportionally. So it changes the height and the width at the same time. Let's make it about 30% of its current size. And that's still a bit too big. Let's do it about 80% of that. Excellent. It's always better to work with really huge images because that means that they're going to print out in really nice quality. It doesn't matter if you have to make them smaller. There we go. That'd be a lovely newspaper layout. It just means that you're going to have to deal with a bit more of information, but that's always going to make it look better in the end. Right. So now that you have your picture laid out, you can see how that how the text is still not reacting to it. Don't panic. It hasn't because you haven't told it to. So if you select your image and come to the text wrap options here on the side. Now what happens if you haven't got these text wrap options on the side? Don't panic. Don't worry. You come up here to Window, find them and make sure you select them. See, if I select them again, they're gonna close because they're already selected before. So you find them and you click it, and that's gonna make sure that it pops up so you can see it. Yeah? Let me bring it close. So you select the image that you want. I want you to select this middle one that looks like a little circle because that means it's going to try and read your image and wrap the text around it. Yeah? See how it tried? It didn't really do a good job because you're not exactly giving it directions just yet. So come down here, it says wrap options, both right and left sides. Yeah, that's absolutely fine. And then in contour options, I want you to select alpha channel. Now alpha channel is what... it's the channel where transparency is. So because you've made the background transparent, when you tell it to read the alpha channel, it's going to read everything that's transparent and everything that's not. See how that immediately adapted the text around his face? Excellent. That's still a bit too tight. So look at how this Q is really close to his face. What you want is that to give that a little bit more space, but not to worry. That's very simple. You just come to this one little bit here that tells you how much space it's going to give you between the image and the text. Right now it's at 0 millimeters, and that's why you have no space. But if you make that higher, see how this text starts to move, and see how this little contour lets you know more or less what it is that you're doing. You can have a play with it a little bit and then try and figure out exactly how you want it to look. Maybe for example here you're getting a couple of words left out at the end. Might need to move Mr. Farage a little bit to the right to make sure that doesn't happen. There you go. And if you want to see how this is going to look once you print it out without all of the bounding boxes, once again, hit W. See how lovely that looks? Excellent. So now you know, if you need to look at the first video to remind yourself how to do a cutout picture again, by all means, go ahead and do it. But once you've got your picture cut out, or if you happen to be lucky enough to find a PNG with a transparency background on the internet that you can use and that is relevant to your story, then this is how you could place it. Here we go. Bye.